Would you like to properly be able to record paying your landlord clients? Well then follow the procedures in this video, Monthly Payouts to Landlords. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What must be recorded in QuickBooks at the moment you send the monthly payouts to all of your landlord clients? Well, here's what your payout report would look like just for Alan. And if you look at it one client at a time, QuickBooks tells you the amount you have to pay. And the amount you have to pay to the client goes out of your bank account as one payment amount, the bottom line of the section of the report for that particular landlord client. But when you record the payment, not only do you have to record one big reduction of your bank account for the total you paid at the moment you paid it, but you also have to record each individual's tenant's balance so that each individual tenant's balance becomes zero at the moment you pay. Again, the amount that's indicated owed for each tenant should become zero, so that you can start fresh in the next month with the next month's transactions. Now, it would be great if we could do everything in one entry the way it would look here. It would be great if we could open the Write a Checks window and record the one payment to Alan that went out of our bank account in one amount, and that payment will make our bank records match the bank statement. And it would be great if we could record it at the same moment that we record making zero each individual tenant's balance, so that in the same window, each amount owed to your landlord client for each tenant would go down to zero, so it could start at zero for the next month. But unfortunately, you can't do that. QuickBooks will not allow you to do them both at the same time in the same window. If you try to do it the way it looks here, you will get this error message. For some reason, it does not let you put more than one accounts receivable type of account in a check transaction at one time. So, what can we do? Well, we'll do something called a workaround. Now you may well ask, what is a workaround? Well, a workaround are the extra steps, or let's say the extra clicks, that we do in order to compensate for what QuickBooks cannot do to achieve the correct results when recording a transaction. Now that might not be the official definition, that's my definition, but I think it's close enough for our purposes today. So, what are we going to do? First, we're going to create a bank type of account, and we're going to call it Already Paid, or something to that effect. Then, we're going to record a payment for each individual tenant's balance, one by one, using the Already Paid bank account. Now that will make each tenant's balance become zero, so it can start, each tenant's balance can properly start fresh at zero for the next month. But what it will all, what we then have to do is record the total payout exactly as it came out of our bank account, and we will use for the total payout the Already Paid account. That will record the transaction in the bank records to make it match the bank statement. So first let's add the clearing account. It's a bank type of account called Already Paid. And it takes 2 seconds. List, chart of accounts, account, new. It's a bank type of account. Click continue and call it something like already paid or some name that indicates that the money has been sent. Click no. The money has been sent to the client. Now, what do we do? Let's actually pay Alan. First of all, this tells us how much to pay. So before we record anything in our QuickBooks, we actually physically send Alan $6,100, whether it be a check from the operating bank account, whether it be a debit card charge or an automatic online transfer. We give $6,100 from the operating bank account, and then we record those steps. So first, we enter each tenant's amount one at a time, and then the balance of the already paid account will be equal to the amount we have to pay Alan. So we click check. Don't forget to put the date as the date that the money actually physically came from our bank account. But we will not use our bank account up top here. We will put the clearing account already paid. Click OK. Now we choose Betty under Alan because we're paying Alan for Betty. And we can take a look at the report and see that the amount that we owe to Alan specifically for Betty is $2,500. So we put $2,500 and we put accounts receivable payable to landlord because that's what's decreasing. We owe less as a result of paying Betty's amount. And we have to choose again the tenant under the landlord for both the top field and the bottom field. Make sure we have the right money amounts. And now when we click save and close, look, we achieved half our goal. We now show that we owe zero to Alan as a result of Betty because that was already paid. Now let's do it for Candy. Check. Same date, same way up here, same account coming from already paid. Alan for Candy, and we said it was $3,600. And of course, we put the accounts receivable type of account, rent payable to landlord client, and put the same landlord and client here. Now when we click save and close, you can see the report says we already paid Betty. We owe her nothing for the current month. We already paid Candy. We owe Alan nothing for Candy for the current month. And now, what will be the result in the trial balance? Well, if we recorded those two things, that means that the amount we owe decreased by the amount that is indicated as already paid. And the already paid bank account should indicate the amount we actually did pay to the landlord, to our client. So that should be the result after we recorded this. Let's take a look. Yes. The amount we already paid is $6,100, and the amount we owe to landlord clients overall decreased by the amount that we indicated we already paid. So now we'll do the last step. We'll simply enter the full amount of the payment in our records, and that last step is very simple. But what should happen in the trial balance if we indicate that we did pay? Well, if we did pay someone $6,100, then our bank account would decrease by $6,100 and become $7,400. And if we already paid it, the clearing account becomes zero. And these should be the results in the trial balance once we record that the amount of each individual landlord's tenant was already paid. So let's take a look. Check. Now, this is how you record it. You record it coming from the bank account. because that's where the money came from, right? The payment is to just Alan, not for any particular tenant, just Alan, because this is the actual payment. And the actual money that went out of the bank account is $6,100. And it came from the clearing account already paid. Save and close. And now the results are exactly as what they should be. This is truly what we have left in the bank account. This is truly what we owe to the other clients whom we haven't paid, because in our example, the only other client is Dave Deeney, and as you can see, we owe him $6,000. So the remainder of what's indicated as owed to clients is correct, the balance of the bank account is correct, and everything else is correct. And this is the way that you would record paying your client. Lastly, the question is, should you send along a statement with your payment? You could modify the landlord payout balances report to be a perfect monthly deposit statement, or you could use the QuickBooks Create Statement feature, but in the case of a property management company, that would not be as good. Watch. We open this report and we want to send something to Alan that explains why did we pay him $6,100. If we could print just this section of Alan for just the month of January, that would be a perfectly appropriate statement, because you can see the check was on the same day, so it explains that these two add up to the total payment that Alan got. So, how do we do that? First, if we use the report as a statement, we filter by customer. So we want only Alan. We click Customize Report, Filter, click in the filter box once and push the letter N as in Nancy or N as in name. And now you can see we're filtering by name. Pull down, choose just Alan, not either of his tenants, just Alan. Click OK. And now you can see the report isolates Alan. Now, what would be step two on this report? Well, step two would be isolate the date range so Alan knows that he's getting a statement specifically for the month of January. You could do this. You could click the pull down. You could go this month. You could go last week or last month, whatever you want. But it's easier if you do, even next month, if you do this, if you simply go from and to, click on the to date box and put the end of the month, put on the from date box and put on the beginning of the month. Now we want to isolate only Alan's transactions between January 1 and January 31, and then click refresh. Now we have only transactions between these dates and only for Alan. Now, what would be the third step? Well, you have a choice. You could print, email, or export to Excel. You could click print, you could click email if that's set up in QuickBooks, or you could export to Excel, make something fancy, and send it out. Now, you could use the QuickBooks statement feature, but it's not as good. You know, for property management, I don't think the statement feature would work. You would click company, and you would, customers, create statements. And then, of course, you would choose a statement date. In this case, the example probably would be the end of January, and the statement period would be from January 1 until January 31. And then you could one customer, just Alan, view it, okay, just this. And then when we preview, this is the way the statement would print out in preview. It would show all the transactions, but in my opinion, it would not be as clear. You can customize the statement to make it a little more fancy, and you can put a company logo. but I don't think it would be as clear to Alan as the report would be. But of course, that's your choice.